This is a song called The Dalai Lama's Candle. And a few years ago now, about 9 years ago now, my wife and I moved into a new house in our hometown of Adelaide, South Australia. Now my wife is called Carmel. Carmel the Magnificent. As we were instructed to call her. We do so gladly. Shortly after we moved into this new house, we thought we'd have a wee housewarming party. Invite all our friends who would then bring presents for the house, as is the custom, as you know. Unfortunately, most of the people we invited were Scottish. So they didn't bring very much. In fact, they stole a couple of things. An old Scottish tradition. This English laddie, a friend of mine, a good musician called Ray Smith, he brought to the party as a present for Carmel, the Magnificent. And myself, brought a little candle, just a wee white candle. That's it. And I said, and he said, well, this is a special candle, Eric. I said, I hope so. I said, this candle was lit from a candle which was lit by a candle that was originally lit by the Dalai Lama. So when you light this candle in your house, the gentle and courageous spirit of the Dalai Lama will fill your house. He said, and if you let it burn for a few days and the spirit permeates your household, if you're really lucky, you and Carmel the Magnificent might start having wild tantric sex. So I said, where have you hidden the matches this time? Sound just like it, don't it? I just come back from a 10-mile jog one morning, and I just finished my usually in prunges. So when I came out of the toilet, I thought, I'd write a song about that Dalai Lama's candle. Just sitting there, the thought just came to me, as well as a few other things. Right, it's been a long tour, hasn't it?
Yes.
Oh, come on. I have a candle that was lit from a candle which was lit from a candle that by the Dalai Lama. It was a present from a friend, a longing follower of Zen. We use his words like gentle priests were on Tibet, and the candlelight is courage seems to shimmer. So I hope his lovely flame will guide him home again, and that one day his long exile will be over. Now I have a photograph, copied from the photograph, from the photograph taken by my mother. It's of me and my dad, and it's the only one I have that shows the both of us together. And I'm living at a 10, I'm not looking at the lens, but it's something far beyond the forest borders. While behind me my dad stands with his big warm hand resting lightly on my shoulder. That's a cutting from a rose planted many years ago by my grandmother. It's called the evening star, it's my favourite rose by far. To me it has a fragrance like no other. For it sends so sweet and clear, takes me back down through the years when the story of my life was still unwritten. And where a blank and happy page say thanks if where I play amongst the roses of my grandmother's garden. Thank you.
say there's a soul that was born from a soul, from among the souls of all the men before us. It's a song in broken line that stretches back through time, a life of time we hear the decent chorus. The reaches from the past that take me gently this grass and turn me to the new day that is dawning. It sings deep inside of me for who I am.
I've got a twin sister still lives in Edinburgh in Scotland. No, we're far away from each other, we're very close, we've been close all our lives emotionally, you know, very fond of her. And a few years ago, she had a very serious operation. So we were waiting in my house in Adelaide, our house in Adelaide, waiting for word from my brother-in-law to see what was after she came out of hospital. And I was a bit worried, you know, and I was pacing about a bit, and Carmel could see I was a bit upset. She said, look, she says, why don't we light the Dalai Lama's candle? Because we never lit, you know, too scared to, I think. And I thought, well, it won't hurt. So I lit it. And I sort of calmed down a bit, you know, and had a few whiskies as well, mind you. But a combined force, you know. Anyway. Oh, about five, because of the time difference, of course, it was very early in the morning at Adelaide. And it was about 4 o'clock in the morning when my brother-in-law finally phoned and said, look, the operation went very well. Looks good. We'll know more tomorrow. I'll ring tomorrow, but it looks good. So I thought, oh, thank God for that, you know. So I leaned forward, the candle had burned down to about this. So I leaned forward to blow it out. My wife said, don't do that. She said, don't do that. She said, I'll go and get another candle. And we'll light it from that candle. Aww. And we'll still have a Dalai Lama's candle. Wait. Never truer. Men are from Mars, women are from Venus.
Yeah.
I was ready to just go, well, that's it. Time for a quickie before we go. See, women are the keeper of the records. Yes. In every family, in every group. They're the ones who keep the Christmas cards and the baby's booties and the locks of hair and all the postcards from overseas and the death notices and the wedding notices. And if it was up to men, we'd have no memories at all. We just were like newborn babies every day. Wake up and start again. But women keep records, and our wee family, Carmel and I, now have a big ball of memories. That I would never have had if it had left up to me. And I'm not saying we sit every night and go through them, but they're there. And that's what women do, they keep it on the records. Pete has got a lovely wife called Nikki, a Scots lady. She thought, I'll share the blood around with an Englishman. And they, yeah.
Spoiled my chances for tonight.
Let me be honest with you.
We've
never had
any. This is being filmed.